Hey there, Happy New Year! So we're actually entering the second week of the new year, the point at which around 30% of half of the population who make New Year's resolutions are going to start giving up on them. I actually conducted a little survey at the end of the year in which I asked you what resolutions you made in 2016 and how many of them you kept, and also which ones you were going to make in 2017 and what faith you had in meeting them. So today I'm going to be talking about those survey results and also about the science behind keeping habits to give you the best shot at succeeding. First things first, I've got to be honest, I didn't do the best job at publicising this survey, so in pure psychological survey style, the sample size is quite small. But interestingly, of the resolutions that I did receive, they all pretty much met the statistical averages. The vast majority were to do with self-improvement, mostly to do with weight, health, and fitness. Now, I actually split these resolutions into three categories: those that involved habit formation, those that involved breaking a habit, and those that were merely punctual events. And I'm going to be focusing specifically on making and breaking habits, because the literature suggests that forming habits is actually a lot simpler than breaking habits. So if you're stuck for choice, then always go for the one that involves making a new habit. And if you are looking to break a habit, it's actually easier to do so by forming a new habit to replace it. It might seem a bit tough to try and do two things at once, but the truth is when you're learning a new habit, you form a competing response, so it'll become easier to perform that habit and therefore you won't have to perform the old bad habit. For instance, if you're trying to quit alcohol, it's much easier to replace the alcohol with, say, a soft drink or something else to do in the place of the alcohol, rather than replacing it with nothing. And this is fortunate, as 70% of resolutions involved habit formation, although interestingly, a larger proportion of resolutions that involved habit breaking were kept in 2016. The opposite is true for 2017 though, but this could just be a product of my sample size. The next question is, how long does it actually take to break a habit? Now, the scientific literature honestly doesn't have a single answer, because the truth is it varies a lot. For example, if a habit is associated with an unpleasant event, then it will be actually very easy to break it. But if there's no unpleasant event and there's no competing habit to replace it, it can be quite tough. Case in point, if you want to quit junk food and you eat a hamburger and it makes you feel very ill, you are likely to be put off hamburgers, so quitting junk food might suddenly become a lot easier. Now, learning a new habit and making it become second nature is quite different though, and it's also a highly variable process. You may have heard the myth that it takes 21 days for a habit to become fixed, but the truth is this is a pseudoscientific observation by a plastic surgeon who claimed that his patients took 21 days to become accustomed to their new faces, which is obviously a completely different situation. Better conducted studies actually show that with daily repetitions, it takes around 10 to 12 weeks on average for a habit to become fixed. But the truth is, it's highly variable. It could take anywhere from 2 weeks all the way up to 36 weeks. And that might sound like a lot of time to invest in daily commitment, but if you go through with it, it does mean that the habit will become fixed at the end. So whilst it might seem a bit harder than just sticking at something for 21 days, there are quite a few things you can do to make the process of habit formation become a lot easier. The first thing is to ensure that the habit you choose is a small one, one with few steps and that is easy to perform, and to tag it onto the end of another pre-existing habit. This could be something like taking a pill with breakfast or walking two stops before catching the bus after work. The other thing, and this might sound counterintuitive, is to always perform the habit in the same way. It's tempting to mix things up and, for instance, go for a walk sometimes before work and sometimes to go after work, but the context in which you perform the habit is essential for the habit to become fixed. Another important thing to remember is to not get discouraged if you slip up. It's quite common for people to give up after failing once, but even if you do miss out on a daily habit, it is easy to pick it up again if it is repeated immediately afterwards without extending the time it takes to fully acquire the habit as second nature. Also, on the topic of repetition and context to make habits stick, the opposite is true as well. Change will make habits change. You may notice that when you go on a holiday, your daily routine or the way you perform certain habits changes, and that means that actually holidays and vacations are perfect opportunities for you to actually introduce new habits or alter old ones. So to sum up, based on this simple science, I think there are five things you can do to make your goals more manageable. 1. Favour goals that involve habit formation rather than habit breaking. 2. make one small change at a time. 3, don't give up immediately, even if it feels like the habits are still very hard to perform.
4, don't give up if you happen to slip up along the way. We are really robust against those slip-ups, so don't worry too much about them. And last but not least, take advantage of holidays and vacations in order to start to make these changes, because it will be a lot easier to do so.
I really hope you enjoyed today's episode and that it was actually useful to you on some level. 2 quick bits of news. Number 1, this is in collaboration with Matt from Conjecture. He makes lots of fun videos about psychology, statistics, and other quirky bits of science, and he's made a video about lay behavioural strategies on how to keep your own New Year's resolutions, so go check that out. And number 2, hablo transmisión en español. Me han invitado a Tube con España, es el 18 de febrero en Madrid, creo que son 15 euritos, me han invitado a mí y a un montón de divulgadores españoles de YouTube. Estoy muy emocionada porque están poniendo muchísimo énfasis en la divulgación y la ciencia y estamos planeando unas actividades que van a ser muy divertidas, así que si puedes acercarte, no te arrepentirás. And as always, thank you so much for watching me, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!